In our travels across the city, from bar vocalists to garage bands, the ultimate question most musicians want to know is, how can I get my record on the radio? Well, radio has changed over the years. Certain precautions had to be put in place after several payola scandals in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Now CD and cassette sales are scanned in music outlets, while radio stations test records to their audiences. Today, our discussion will center on how the decision to add a record to a radio station's playlist is made. We caught up with the operations manager of WGCI-FM, Elroy Smith, at a promotional dinner for LaFace Records newcomer Usher Raymond. Urban Street asked Elroy to take us through how WGCI adds records to its playlist.
Much when I say we, myself and the music director, we meet every Thursday for our weekly music meeting, and we listen to a variety of artists, whether they are established or not, new artists. We listen to the sound. Does the sound of this record fit the radio station? Sometimes it may not fit the radio station during the day, but it may fit in the evening, where we have a more radical approach in terms of music. We put newer music on quickly in the evening. Now, for Usher Raymond, we said, okay, fine, he's a teen-oriented type of artist. Let's try him out on our 6 to 10 show, which has a huge teen following. We tried it there, and it worked there. So we said, well, why not expand it beyond 6 to 10 p.m.? So we brought it into Afternoon Drive with Doug Banks. And then we said, okay, let's open it up all throughout the day. Because the song fit well on the station. Now, if it didn't fit, if it sounded like a sore thumb on the radio station, it probably doesn't belong there.
Back I get deeper and deeper, help you reach the climax that your man can't make. Call him, tell him you'll be home real late and sing the break. I got that good love, girl, you didn't know.
With mega producers Jammin' Lewis, Puff Daddy, Babyface, and Dr. Dre ruling the record charts, how does WGCI not become a station of music produced by five or six producers?
We are not producer-driven. We are not artist-driven. We are song-driven. So if the song fits, it's going to get on. Luther Vandross's last album, there were certain songs that just did not fit WGCI. But it's Luther Vandross. Well, I know it is. But since we are song-driven instead of artist-driven, we got to go by the song. So a lot of record people now understand that we just don't play an artist because they have had 50 million hits in the past. The typical thing is, what have you done for me lately? With the one you love.
Attempted to do is create music and help contribute to an era in black music that is as important as Motown or Philly International or what Atlantic Record was in the 60s. We're really trying to sort of take all the music of our generation they like to call it Generation X, you know. Take all the music of Generation X, whether it be straight ahead R&B music, whether it be R&B music that crosses over and becomes pop music, whether it's rap music, whether it's alternative music, whether it's jazz, or whether it's adult music. What we try to do is take all of that and say, that's who we are, that's what we're about. We represent the rhythm of black lifestyles. We represent music for all people, but created by black people.
I know what you're doing, yeah. I know why you dialed my number. I know what you're doing, yeah. I know why you care. I know what you're doing.
Well, I have to, again, be true to myself, and we have to realize that what I'm doing is black music. We helped create all of this, if not we created it. Pop music is the black experience. It's just gone in other directions. It's been developed in different ways. But that's the basis of all music is black music, is blues, is soul, is gospel. You know, so see, these are things that we have to reclaim as black people. We can't say that, well, you can only listen to this and you can only listen to that and the rest of the world can listen to everything else. Uh-uh. We can listen to everything if we want to, and we should be able to do that, but it seems as though we've ghettoized our music, and if you don't have an 808 beat, it's not black. Come on, that's ridiculous.
I don't like the idea of, okay, well, I'll experiment with your record. Okay, and I'll experiment with your record. I'll experiment with your record. Here's what we have. We have a playlist of 30 experimental songs, and they could all be non-hits, and I got my competitor playing the hits. So, and trust me, I like to find new songs or new artists. But just to do that, to say, yeah, we do break new artists and the song is not happening, that's dangerous. I mean, keep in mind that the average listener, when they turn on the radio, 9 times out of 10, if they don't hear a song that they are familiar with, they are gone to another radio station. So we need to instantly grab that listener. They're not going to sit around and wait 4 or 5 records before they hear a song that they can sing along to. So I got to keep that in mind.
Profanity, does it sound like the radio station? And we're less critical because it is, you know, a Chicago group who's trying to get on the radio. And if it goes beyond that, you know, we'll be very, very excited to see them go beyond just being heard in Chicago. Listeners should be able to determine that it's GCI with their eyes closed. You know, they should be able to close their eyes and go up and down the dial and say, well, that's GCI. Only because we have a certain sound. And when we deviate from that sound, that confuses the listener.